Log Talk Radio.
You're about to witness a seismic event. Now, let the party begin. Get ready to experience the sounds of...
This is, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Please welcome.com. Are you ready to be blessed? Are you ready to experience the magic of praise and worship? Or are you ready to experience the magic?
Thank you for tuning in to Word of Flame Radio with your host, Apostle Arthur Timberlake.
Blessings, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Amen. We thank God, amen, for yet another day. Welcome each and every last one of you to this, our daily devotion. Amen. Word of Flame Radio is on the air. I am your host, Apostle Arthur Timberlake. Amen. Glory be to God. We are just again elated, amen, to be here. And let me tell you, no physical reason, amen, glory be to God. We just pure air. No marijuana, no alcohol, just pure air. Amen, glory be to God. Running on full thrusters, amen, glory be to God. Gung-ho, ready to go, amen, glory be to God. Full of the joy of the Lord, glory to God, which is our strength. Amen. Glory be to God to continue on despite it all. Glory be to God. Abasha. Hey, despite it all. Amen. Glory be to God. We carry on. Bless his holy and wonderful name. Amen. Bless you on the phone lines in the chat room. Amen. You that are listening, wherever you're listening from on the face of this planet. We thank God, amen, for you being here. Amen. Tonight we're going to deal with some things. Amen. Glory be to God. I'm telling you, there's a message. Amen. And it's funny that God has just been, he's just been dealing with me for the last few days. Amen. Glory be to God. But there's a message. Amen. Your dream only appears dead, it shall live. Somebody needs to speak that, amen, into their lives. I'm going to talk about it. I'm not going to get ahead of myself. But, amen, glory be to God. Your dreams appear dead. Ah, oh, but they shall live. Amen and amen and amen. Glory to God. Look, I'm getting ready to play another song. I want y'all to tell me if y'all can figure out, amen, who this singer is. Be right back.
Oh, my, my. I'd like to thank God for his good and his blessings he has bestowed upon me. See, when I look back over my life to see where he brought me from, I can truly say that I've been blessed. I woke up this morning, got out of my bed, and I looked around. Here's what I said. Thank you, Lord, for the blood you shed. You put a roof upon my head. Thank you, Lord, for another day. Know this blessing you send my way. Could have been days living in my grave, but you told death is my hand and behave.
Another blessing. Amen. Another blessing. Amen. That was yours truly. Amen. We did a recording, amen, of several songs on the Ernie Miles Show. Amen. Out of Monroe, Louisiana. Amen. Glory be to God. Those broadcasts, amen, are still going on even to this day. Amen. I cannot step in the Tallulah area or Monroe area and people not know, amen, the ooh-wee man, the ooh-wee, another blessing. Amen. Glory to God. Everywhere, amen, we turn out, every church, amen, they want me to sing, amen, that song. Amen. Glory be to God. We'll get the others, amen, as quickly as possible and get them up here. Amen. Amen. Amen, Mr. Robin Lynn. Amen. We're going to do just that. Amen. Let's open up in a word of prayer. Father, God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, first and foremost, for what you've done for each and every one of us over 2,000 years ago in sending your precious Son, amen, to shed his precious blood for each and every last one of our sins, to wash them away, Lord God, to blot out all our transgressions, and to give us the right to the tree of life. We glorify your holy and your wonderful name. Glory be to God for all of your many benefits, all of the things that you've done for us, all of the things that you're doing right now, and all the things that you're yet going to do. Father, we take all of our care and we cast them before you, Lord God. Ah, we're casting all our care upon you right now. Glory to God, because you care for each and every one of us. God, we thank you. Glory to God for bearing our burdens. Glory be to God for answering our prayers, for moving on our behalf in the precious name of Jesus. Hey, glory to God. We love you. Glory be to God, and we thank you. Hey, we thank you. We bless you, Lord God. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah, God, we thank you. Move. Oh, on the behalf of your people, Lord. Oh, we need you tonight. We need you right now, God. We need you each and every day. Each and every day. We can't do anything without you. Hallelujah. Be it everything that we say, everything that we do tonight. Let your word, Lord God, come forth with power and with great conviction. Let it bless us. Let it empower us, Lord God. Let it mobilize us. Glory to God. Give us, Lord God, every last one of us, what we need tonight. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, we give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor you so richly deserve right now. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, my. Precious Lord, let me see, how does it go? Take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I'm worn. Hallelujah. My. Oh, I feel good tonight, y'all. I feel good tonight. I'm telling you, amen. Glory be to God. With all of the things that have been happening, amen. Glory be to God. I am overjoyed. I am overjoyed. Count it all joy. joy when you fall into divers temptations. The Bible says, amen, all of these different tests, amen, all of these different trials, all these tribulations, amen, glory be to God, that come to make you strong, that come, glory be to God, to build the character of God on the inside of you, hallelujah, glory to God, to call, that come to, amen, make you think like God, amen, to act like God, to talk like God, to walk like God, glory be to God, I see, to do what God would do. Yeah, indeed, amen, glory be to God. Boy, we gonna have a time tonight. We're going to have a time tonight. I want to play, man, another song, and I'll be right back.
There's a song I want to do right now that reminds me of my grandmother, and you've heard me tell my story how she prayed me through. When I got saved, when I got delivered from drugs and alcohol, my grandmother, she told me, she said, there's a song I want you to learn, and when you come back to my church, I want you to sing it.
It for the Lord on my side, tell me where would I be? Where would I be?
Yeah!
Bless his holy and wonderful name. Amen and amen and amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Minister Robin Lynn is waiting on you. Amen. Glory to God is waiting on you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Well, we want to go ahead and get into this word. Amen. On tonight. I'm so excited about it. Amen. Glory be to God. I really am. God has been dealing with me for a couple of days now. We have been praying, amen, concerning certain situations, amen. Well, of course, death is inevitable, amen. My wife's father, amen, passed away on Tuesday, amen. Glory to God. She's going, amen, in the morning, and I'm soliciting your prayers, amen, for traveling mercy. Amen. She's going in the morning to, amen, Mobile, Alabama, amen, to participate with a family. Amen. Glory be to God. And, amen, it's going to be a wonderful home going. Amen. I wish that we were all able to go, but, amen, we thank God, amen, for that. But I got some news, amen, on yesterday, day before yesterday, amen. No, it was yesterday. I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep up with my days and nights, amen. But got some news, amen, the other day concerning my granddaughter, amen, trying to commit suicide. Some things, amen, going on up in Cleveland. Amen. I pray that you would help me pray for them as well. Amen. Glory be to God. I know that any time the adversary, amen, gets into somebody's head, amen, to that degree, there is something terribly wrong going on. Amen. She's only 12 years old. Amen. And her 13th birthday is this month on the 13th. Isn't that something? Amen. Glory to God. The adversary trying to take her out, amen, before she even has an opportunity, a chance, amen, to live her life, amen. So many other things going on, amen, glory be to God. And many questioning, amen, even on today, what's going on with our relationship with God? Why is it that we're praying and he doesn't seem to be answering? What is the problem? What is going on? What's happening? Why does it seem God is contrary to his word today? Why does it seem, amen, God is not answering, amen, or coming to the aid of his people? There was a time when, amen, you could just think a thought, and God, amen, would come and he would deal with the situation. He would deal with the circumstance. He would answer the prayer. Amen. There were times you didn't even get on your knees and talk to God about certain things. Amen. And God would meet those things that were just minute thoughts in your head. Amen. Glory be to God. Seemed like God was there. Amen. Quickly. Amen. He was right there. But amen, now it seems like, and you know, it's a lot of people going through changes right now. People being robbed. Amen. Glory be to God. They're being tempted above measure. Amen. To sin. To go back into the world. Amen. Glory be to God. So many things taking place, amen, the temptation to kill, the temptation to steal, amen, the temptation to do a lot of things, amen, glory be to God, people have no business doing. But amen, glory be to God, there is a word from the Lord. There is a word from the Lord. In the midst of all the travesties and all of the trials and the tribulations, all of the things that are taking place, amen, in our world, that there is a word from the Lord. And it's funny that God would begin to deal with me, amen, concerning Jeremiah. Because, you know, God is speaking to his people. He's talking to us. He's telling us, amen, that he's going to bless. He's telling us, amen, to hold on. Things are going to be okay. Amen, glory be to God. But I'm here to tell you, amen, glory be to God, Jeremiah had an issue with God. Jeremiah had an issue with God. Amen. Jeremiah, amen, was doing what the Lord told him to do. And, amen, every time he turned around, something contrary was taking place in his life. Every time, amen, glory be to God, he stepped out to do what God called him to do, amen, glory be to God, something would jump off, amen, something would happen, amen, and have him looking like, amen, he was a fool. Jeremiah says it this way in Jeremiah chapter 20, verse number 7. He says it this way. He says, "O Lord, thou hast deceived me." Oh, my God. That right there just lays me out. Now, listen at this now. Listen at his conversation. I want you to hear his heart. He says, "Oh, Lord, thou hast deceived me, and I was deceived. Thou art stronger than I and hast prevailed. I am in derision daily." Now, that word derision means that he's being ridiculed. He's being mocked. He's being talked about. He's being laughed at. The Bible says, amen, he goes on to say, "Everyone mocketh me." He's letting us know, amen, that he has become a derision daily. People are not taking him seriously. People are laughing at him, talking about him like a dog. Because what he's saying out of his mouth, amen, glory be to God, is not happening. As a matter of fact, the exact opposite of what he's saying out of his mouth is taking place. So then, amen, he's coming off like he's a false prophet. He's coming off, amen, glory be to God, like he don't know what the devil he's talking about. And Jeremiah's confused. He's kind of messed up behind this. He says, "For since I spake, I cried out. I cried violence and spoil, because the word of the Lord was made a reproach unto me, and a derision daily." Listen to what he's saying. The things I'm saying out of my mouth, the exact opposite is taking place. Nobody's taking me seriously. Everybody's talking about me like a dog. None of what I said is coming to pass. Well, I've been with Jeremiah. I've been there. Hey, glory to God, I've been there. I'm telling you now, I've been there. Understand the confusion. Because, see, in a lot of people's minds, everything is supposed to be hunky-dory. Everything that you say out of your mouth is supposed to come to pass. Everything is supposed to be just like you say. But I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell you, woo, glory be to God. See, when you got a real calling upon your life, God going to take you through some changes. You hear what I say? I said, God going to take you through some changes. Ah, oh my God, can you still serve him even though it seems like he's the one who's against you? Can you still praise his holy name even though it seems like he's the one who's against you? Hey, glory to God. Can you still, amen, give him praise and glory even though it seems like he's the one who's destroying you? Listen at the word of the Lord. Verse number 9, "Then I said, I will not make mention of it. Brethren, I've been here." You hear what I say? I've been here, so confused, so messed up, because in my mind, amen, glory be to God, I shouldn't be in this predicament. As a matter of fact, according to them, amen, they preach faith all the time. All I got to do is speak to my situation, speak to my circumstance, and everything is going to be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, that everything is going to be okay. The devil is a liar. That devil is a liar. Amen, glory be to God. Some people, amen, got us thinking, amen, that we walk around here with this magical power on the inside. We can automatically change everything around us simply by speaking it out of our mouth. And that ain't so. Jesus said out of his own mouth, which one of you can add one cubit to his stature simply by taking thought? None one of us can. We don't have no power except God give it to us. We don't have nothing. Then I said, I will not make mention of him, nor speak any more in his name. I'm telling you, brother, and I've been here. So confused, so distraught, so messed up because everything is so contrary. God got us looking like we crazy. We speaking, amen, that God is going to move, that God is going to punish these evildoers. And it looks like, amen, those evildoers, amen, are doing better and better and better and better. Look like they're more happier and happier and happier. And we are, amen, glory be to God, being torn down, amen, in the midst of it all. Jeremiah was tripping because, amen, he was in prison. Here's the man of God in prison, in stocks, steadily speaking the word of the Lord, and none of what he said coming to pass. Now, somebody better hear me. Oh, glory to God. See, God got a way about him. God got a way about him, y'all. Oh, glory to God. Yes, indeed, he's got a way about him. Listen at this. Listen at this. But he says, I'm not going to make mention of him. I ain't going to speak no more in his name. But his word was in mine heart as a burning fire shut up in my bones. And I was weary with forbearing and could not stay. I couldn't hold my peace. Every time, amen, something jumped off his word, amen, was burning in my bosom. I had no choice but to speak. Hey, glory be to God. See, woo, glory to God. There's some things, amen, that God will do in your life to let you know that you are still his. There's some things, amen, glory be to God, God will speak to you. God will allow his word to burn in your bosom. Amen, glory be to God, despite your circumstances, despite your situation, God has a way of letting you know he's still with you. So the Bible says, for I heard the defaming of many. I heard them talking. Fear on every side. Report, say they, and we will report it. All my familiars watched for my halting. These people are looking for me to fall. Looked for me to fail. Saying peradventure, which means perhaps, he will be enticed. And we shall prevail against him, and we shall take our revenge on him. Do you understand what that passage of scripture is saying? It's saying that his enemies wanted to do him harm, but they couldn't. Says, oh my God, thank you, Jesus. Despite what he was going through, Jeremiah was still walking upright before God. And God was still protecting him. They couldn't do anything against him. Your enemies can't touch you unless they can cause you to fall. Satan can't put his hands on you unless he causes you to fall. If he can get you to sin, he's got you. Hayaba, yeshanda babamusa. This is what he said, but the Lord is with me as a mighty terrible one. Therefore my persecutors shall stumble, and they shall not prevail. They shall be greatly ashamed, for they shall not prosper. Their everlasting confusion shall never be forgotten. Now listen to the man of God. But, O Lord of hosts, that trieth the righteous. Listen to what he says now. That triest the righteous, and seest the rein and the heart. Let me see thy vengeance on them, for unto thee have I opened my cause. Sing unto the Lord, praise ye the Lord, for he hath delivered the soul of the poor from the hand of evildoers. Now listen to what he said. He did praise God. First, he's levied his complaint. Then he turns around and he praises God. And then he does something real weird. Verse 14. Cursed be the day wherein I was born. Let not the day wherein my mother bare me be blessed. Cursed be the man who brought tidings to my father, saying, a man child is born unto thee. Making him very glad. And let that man be as the cities which the Lord overthrew, and repent it not. And let him hear the cry in the morning and the shouting at noontime. Because he slew me not from the womb. Or that my mother might have been my grave, and her womb to be always great with me. Wherefore came I forth out of the womb to see labor and sorrow, that my days should be consumed with shame? Listen to what he said. He didn't levy his complaint. Praise God. Talk about what the Lord going to do for him, how he's going to avenge him and bless him. And then he turns around and he falls backward again. Well, isn't that how that goes with each and every last one of us when we have been tormented so? When we've been in such a terrible battle, when we've been faced with such great tribulation, and tribulation is pressure, y'all. That's pressure, pressure of the mind. Tribulation works on your mind. It brings pressure in your mind, causes thoughts, amen, that bring pressure, that, amen, glory be to God, wear you down. 1 minute, amen, you're talking good. The next minute, you're tripping. Amen. The next minute, you're talking good again. The next minute, you're tripping. I don't know about the rest of y'all. Been there, done that. Hello, somebody. Amen. Glory be to God. Been there, done that. Amen. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Look at Job. Another brother. Amen. Glory be to God. 1 minute, he glorifying God. The next minute, he tripping. If you remember, amen, the concourse, the conversation between them. 1 minute, amen, he's lifting up the Lord. The next minute, he's tripping. That's, amen, that's what happens when you've been in a battle for so long. When it seems like God himself is against you. When, amen, nothing, amen, you do, nothing you say, amen, is taking grip. Nothing is happening. Oh, glory be to God. I'm going to say it again. Your dream only appears to be dead. It shall live. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. I want y'all to understand something. Amen. Now watch this. Lord, I'm in Matthew chapter 14. Matthew chapter number 14. I want you to start right there at verse number 22. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to his name. Glory to his name. God bless each and every last one of you. Amen. Glory to God. Revival Fire, Patriot Greg. Amen. Minister Robin Lynn. Everybody, I see my cousins on the line. God bless you. Women of God, great women of God, great women of faith. Amen. Glory be to God. All the way up in New Jersey. God bless you. Amen. Glory be to God. My wife on the line. Everybody, God bless you. Everybody, amen, who's listening under the sound of my voice, God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for being here with us on tonight. Amen. Matthew chapter, amen, 14, starting at verse 22. I want you to see this. The Bible says, and straightway Jesus constrained his disciples to get into a ship and to go before him unto the other side, while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had, amen, sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, in the Sea of Galilee, y'all. Amen. Glory be to God. 7 miles one way, 21 miles the other way. Amen. Glory be to God. I think it was 21 miles, amen, in its depth. Amen. 7 miles, amen, in its width, or whatever the case may be. It wasn't that big. Some of us would call it a lake. But amen. Glory be to God. The Sea of Galilee, they're in the midst of it. The Bible says, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. Here Jesus has told them to go on to the other side. But the wind is contrary. I'm going to say it again. I said, Jesus told them to go on the other side, but the wind is contrary. Oh, Shia, glory to God, glory to God. Jesus told them to go to the other side, but the wind was contrary. They're tossed with the waves because the wind was contrary. It was contrary. It opposed them. But understand this. Hey, glory to God. The winds wasn't opposing them. It was opposing Jesus. Here's another lesson. Amen. Glory be to God. For each and every last one of us to understand. Glory to God. Whatever God says to do, whatever instruction he gives you, amen, fulfill that. I don't care how contrary things are in your life, amen, fulfill what he told you to do. The Bible says in verse number 25, and in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a spirit. And they cried out for fear. Oh, my. See, it's funny when you've never seen a thing done before, you automatically attribute it, amen, to some evil spirit. But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, be of good cheer, it is I, be not afraid. Oh, and then here come Peter. Amen. Y'all know the great concourse between him and Jesus. Amen. If it be you, bid me to come walk on the water with you. Jesus told them to go to the other side, but the wind was contrary. I'm here to tell you, amen, glory be to God, if the Lord tells you to do something and there's no opposition, you better question, amen, glory be to God. Somebody hear me real good. I said if a person says that the Lord, amen, told them to do something and there is no opposition, you might want to check that thing. Because, see, like I said, there's a lot of people, amen, with this faith movement and all this other kind of stuff. Got us, amen, got us believing that everything is supposed to be all right all the time. Everything is supposed to always work in our favor. Everything is supposed to always be good. Nothing should be bad. And if there's anything bad in your life, amen, then that means your relationship with God is not right. But I'm here to tell you, amen, glory be to God, God's set that record straight in the day of Job. He set that record straight. Caused people to understand. You could be walking upright and still go through many of the afflictions of the righteous. But the Lord delivereth him out of them all. Oh, glory to God. I'm feeling all right tonight. Amen. John chapter 11, verse number 23. I'm almost done, brethren. I'm almost done. Lord have mercy. I'm telling you, God is, amen, gave me, amen, a shot in my arm. All I can tell you, amen, glory be to God, is I feel good. I feel good, amen, glory be to God, I feel good. Hallelujah. Oh, despite it all, amen, glory be to God, despite what the adversary is doing, how he's fighting, amen, glory be to God, I feel good down in my sanctified soul. John 11 and 23, amen, glory be to God, I feel good down in my sanctified soul. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Jesus simply said unto her, thy brother shall rise again. Thy brother shall rise again. Your dream only appears dead, brethren. It shall live. Now, in this familiar passage of Scripture, we see that the word was sent to Jesus when Lazarus was sick. And the note stated, watch this, he whom thou lovest is sick. Note this now. Note the statement. He whom thou lovest is sick. But Jesus didn't move. As a matter of fact, he said this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Now, Lord have mercy. I just got to throw this in here. There's some things, amen, that each and every last one of us are going through that God has established, amen, to bring glory into your life. There's some trials and some tribulations, some things that are taking place in your life that are designed to bring glory. If you just stay the course, If you would just hold on to God's unchanging hand and not surrender, amen, to defeat, not give up, amen, glory be to God. If you would just refuse to believe that God is against you, that God, amen, somehow is not going to do what he said he was going to do. If you, amen, would just refute that lying devil, amen, glory be to God, and stand your ground, God is going to bless you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. We're in a predicament, amen, where people are walking away from us. They're not, they've left us high and dry. Don't you know that was the will of God? Don't you know, amen, glory to God, everything that he's stripping you of, amen, everything that he's getting out of your life, amen, is not for you. Amen. Glory to God, would not stand with you, amen, in the battle, in the midst of the battle. You need folks, amen, in your life that are going to stand. If y'all remember, amen, I told you there's a difference, amen, glory be to God, in an ox and a donkey. When you're talking about being yoked together, amen, glory be to God, you don't want an unbeliever. You don't, amen, glory be to God, want somebody who's weak in the faith, neither. You want somebody, amen, glory be to God, who's just like you. Y'all better hear me real good. See, let me tell you something. An ox, amen, no matter how heavy the load is, we'll keep on pulling. We'll keep on striving. We'll keep on, amen, glory be to God, because that's their DNA. That's the way they're made. Amen, glory be to God. No matter how, amen, strong the battle is, they keep on going. They, amen, buckle down, amen. They strengthen themselves. They fortify themselves, and they keep on pushing. But a donkey, when, amen, glory be to God, things get too heavy for him, will sit down. Son of Osiah, glory be to God, will sit down on you. You don't need no donkey. You need another oxen. The patient may suddenly Jesus didn't move for 2 days. Then he said to the disciples, watch this, let's go to Judea again. Not trying to go through the entire dialogue, but Jesus tells them that Lazarus is dead. And neither one of them said to him, I thought you said this sickness was not unto death. You know, most folks today would have done that. I thought you said. See, I knew you was a false prophet. I can't follow you because you don't know what you're talking about. It's funny, y'all. They will quote that part and forget entirely the rest of what he said. It's for the glory of God, that the Son might be glorified thereby. They forget about all of that. I'm going to leave that alone. Amen, glory be to God. But I'm right about it. Carnal-minded people only look for fault. That's all they look for. They look for fault. Carnal-minded people only look for fault, y'all. And they never see anything good. Everything that you said right, everything that you did right, they missed all of that. All that went straight over their head. All they caught was one word. All they caught was one line. All they caught was one movement. All they caught was one eye look. Hey, glory to God. But if you look at verse number 15, man, he tells his disciples, I know that you have some unbelief in yourself, but this is going to make believers out of you. This right here is going to make believers out of you. In Acts chapter 1, verse 24. Then they pray, Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which of these two you've chosen. In Deuteronomy chapter number 8, verse number 2, the Bible says, remember how the Lord your God led you all the way in the desert these 40 years to humble you and test you in order to know what was in your hearts. Let me just kindly remind you that the things that we face, the things that we're going through, amen, glory be to God, is nothing but a test. It's a test of your tenacity. It's a test of your persistence. It's a test of your love, your faith, your desire, amen, glory be to God, to make it all the way in. Hey, glory be to God. Every step of the way, if y'all remember, he tells us, amen, glory be to God, about this narrow way. He tells us, amen, glory be to God, about this narrow way. There's all kinds of obstacles on this path. There's all kinds of things, amen, glory be to God, designed to discourage you, designed to stop you from moving forward. I've never, amen, in my life seen so many people, amen, tempted to walk away from God, to give up their relationship with the Lord. But it's happening. People are so distraught. They don't understand that God is testing them, that he's trying them. You remember he says in his word that he would send a shaking. A shaking was going to take place, and anything that could be shaken out of the way would be shaken out of the way, so that the things that cannot be shaken would remain. Which one are you? Are you stable? Hallelujah! Hey! Hey! Are you bending down? Glory be to God. Are you in this thing for the long haul? Glory be to God. Look at what he said. Oh, glory to God. Now, looking at those two verses, it almost sounds like a contradiction, but it's not. Because God does know what's in everybody's heart, which is why he's a master at designing just the right situation or circumstance to develop his character in us, to develop greater faith, to develop, amen, a greater tenacity, a greater determination. Come on, hear somebody. Amen. Glory be to God. Some of us, amen, we've had it so good for so long, we didn't forget what it means to fight. We didn't forget what it means to walk. We didn't forget what it means to wait. Glory be to God. We've had it so good for so long. We've gotten soft. Spoiled, even. I know I was. He wants us to know through these times that he knows us all too well. This was a situation designed by God to bring glory to his name and to glorify his son, Jesus Christ. Same thing, amen, with each and every last one of us. Those of us, amen, that are faced with serious dilemmas, serious situations even now. And I want y'all to understand something. Watch this. We need to stop looking at them like that. We need to stop, amen, glory be to God, magnifying those problems. Amen, and start magnifying the Lord. Hello, somebody. What it means to magnify the Lord is to make him bigger than your problems, to make him bigger than your circumstance. Amen, glory be to God. I heard somebody say amen one day. Instead of amen telling, amen, glory be to God, Jesus, about your problems, tell your problems about your Jesus. Amen, tell them, amen, glory be to God, how they have no power to stand in the face of your God. Amen, glory be to God. They have no ability to overcome you. They have no ability to bring you down. Glory be to God. Somebody, woo, glory be to God. Another soul. I've got to give him praise. Hallelujah. Hey! Everybody was weeping. And they were down about Lazarus being dead. He's been in the grave for 4 days now. Jesus waited for a reason. See, because the Jews believe that even after a person dies, their soul is still lingering around the body. And to keep them from thinking that his soul returned on its own, he waited until they thought he was gone. How many times have we lost faith because God didn't work things out like we wanted him to? How many times did we want God to do something for us so that, watch this now, so that someone you had a problem with would see that God answers your prayers? Vision fell to the ground. A loved one left you. Some disappointment, some letdown, left you empty and discouraged, frustrated, and let's be honest, a little angry with God. Now, I don't know about the rest of y'all, Amen. Glory be to God. Maybe y'all have had y'all stuff together. Amen. Glory be to God from day number one. But Apostle Timberlake, amen, glory be to God, is preaching from experience tonight. Been there, done that. Was in the same predicament, amen, as Jeremiah. Glory be to God. I'm speaking your word. I'm saying the things you're telling me to say. And yet, amen, glory be to God, I'm a derision. Amen. People are mocking me. They're talking about me like a dog. Amen. People, amen, glory be to God, amen, are laughing at me the whole nine yards. Everything I'm saying, amen, seem like it's falling to the ground. Oh, but I'm telling you, glory be to God, stand your ground. God is not unrighteous. Yeah. Oh, glory be to God, he's not unrighteous. He's testing us. Will you still come after me, even though it seems like I'm the one that's against you? Will you still lift me up? Will you still believe? Will you still trust me despite it all? Oh, glory to God. He sent me to tell somebody, just like the raising of Lazarus from the dead, your dream, it only appears dead. It shall live. God wants us to know that we may have failed the test, but he's given his people a new beginning. What a new purpose. Roll the stone away. Call that thing you gave up, amen, glory be to God, gave up on, out of the grave. Wherever you put it, call it out of there. Call your Lazarus back from the dead. This time, stand your ground. This time, believe and don't you doubt. This time, don't be afraid of what you don't understand. This time, pass the test. Learn the lesson. Let him mold you and make you what he wants you to be. We need to stop fighting God's will for our lives, y'all. He's the potter. We're the clay. Suddenly die because of your dream only appears dead. This can be caused by it shall live. Blood flow, or some of us have been called to do some things we don't want to do. But you can't walk into your true blessings until you surrender. And to all the naysayers who blame you for the failure, to all the people who say that it won't be, God himself is against it. That's why nothing is happening. Tell them that your dream only appears dead. It shall live. Mary and Martha sent for Jesus, but he didn't come when they thought he should. He came when all seemed lost, when no one, and I mean no one, could get the glory but God. I say again, your dream only appears dead. Your vision only appears dead. It shall live. Glory to the here in the Messiah. Yeah, it's so. Yeah, it's so. Here in the Messiah. Yeah, it's so. Glory to God. Woo, glory to God. Yeah. Glory to God. And I thank God. I thank God, amen, for his bountiful blessing. I thank God, amen, glory be to God. I thank God. Let me tell you something. Seems like it's over. Seems like everything falling apart. But don't you believe that. Y'all remember, amen, glory be to God, that soldier was bringing Jesus to his home. And the people met him. This was right after the woman with the issue of blood had been healed. They came and told him, trouble not the master. The child is dead. Immediately when Jesus heard what he said, he told Jairus, be not afraid, only believe. I'm going to say it again. Be not afraid, only believe. Hey, glory be to God. God has a tendency of calling us, amen, to do the very things we think we ain't qualified to do. Oh, glory be to God. He's notorious for that, y'all. Call you to do some things. Amen, glory be to God. You don't believe you qualify, amen, to do. But when God calls you, He qualifies you. He gives you everything you need and some. I feel good down in my sanctified soul. I don't know about the rest of y'all, but I need God every day. I need Him all day. Every day. When I get up in the morning, when I go through the course of the day, when I lie down at night, I need Him. That a songwriter say, I need Thee, oh, I need Thee. I need Thee, oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to Thee. I need, hallelujah, Thee, oh, I need Thee every hour. I need Thee, oh, bless me now, my Savior. Ah, I come to Thee. Oh, yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! 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 Oh, glory! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! My soul says yes, 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 my Lord. My soul says yes. Yes, yes, my soul says yes, 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 my Lord, my soul says yes, 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 in the morning, yes, 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 my Lord, in the morning, yes, 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 in the noonday, yes. Yes, yes, my Lord, in the noonday, yes, 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 in midnight, yes, 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 my Lord, in midnight, yes, 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 hallelujah, my soul says yes, 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 my Lord, my soul says yes, 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 ooh, ooh, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, Satan, you know you lost another one, you lost another one, you lost another one, you lost another one, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, let the praises of the Lord ring forth out of your mouth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, give Him praise. Give Him glory. Give Him honor. Hallelujah. For He alone is worthy. He's worthy. Oh, yes, He is. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Glory. Oh, glory to your name, Lord. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, God. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, I bless your holy and wonderful name. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. Oh, if you would just worship, if you would just praise him, if you would just glorify him, if you would just, amen, glory be to God, render unto God so sweetly your praises, amen, in your own way. Just glorify him. I feel a breakthrough in the spirit. I feel, amen, glory be to God, the Lord is moving by his spirit even now. I believe, amen, glory be to God. And glory to God of a fire. Yea, God of a saki and the soul. Rama in the fire. Hey, Abagalamidisi. Hey, Abagal. Hey, hallelujah. Here in the Mosai. Here in the Vidisi. Rama sa. In the soul, Rama. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Glory to your name. Oh, lifting up holy hands. Oh, when I feel wrath. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah, God. Hallelujah. Oh, mighty God. Oh, mighty God. Oh, mighty God. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Ooh, hallelujah.
Cholesterol can't dissolve in the blood.
It has hallelujah. Oh, I can't help myself tonight. I'm so full. I'm so full. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Oh, God, I believe you. I believe your word. I stand on it, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, Lord, I stand on your word. I stand on your word. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. Hallelujah, I thank you. Hallelujah. Oh, glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Oh, oh, oh. Mighty God, oh, he's moving for somebody right now. Oh, he's blessing somebody right now. Glory to God. Oh, you got to do, amen, glory be to God, is praise him. Glorify his holy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God's got a blessing for you. God's got a blessing for you. You can have it. Just reach up and grab it. God's got a blessing for you. Oh, God's got a blessing for you. God's got a blessing for you. You can have it. Just reach up and grab it. God's got a blessing for you. Yes, he does. 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 Oh, glory. Yes, he does. Hey, hallelujah. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Glory to your name, Lord. Glory to your name. You're right on time, God. You're right on time, God. I thank you. I bless you. I lift up your holy and your wonderful name. Nobody like you nowhere. Ever have been nor ever will be. Nobody. 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 Glory to God. There's nobody greater. Nobody better. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brother, amen, glory be to God, praise is comely, it's comely, and we, amen, glory be to God, we owe him, I don't care the circumstances, situation, amen, I done explained to y'all some of the things, amen, going on in my life, amen, financially, amen, glory be to God, socially, family members, amen, going through, amen, glory be to God, oh my God, attempted suicide, different things of this nature, amen, glory be to God, the adversary is, amen, he's doing his job, we need to be doing ours, we need to be glorifying God, in the midst of it all, I praise, in the midst of it all, I praise, amen, glory be to God, I'm turning into the storm, and I'm facing that storm, amen, with praise and my
mouth. Amen. Dripping from my lips. Amen. I will not take down. I will not, amen, glory be to God, fall back. I will not apologize for, amen, my faith in God. I'm standing on his word, and I'm shaking the devil off. I'm shaking off despair. I'm shaking off hopelessness. I'm shaking it all off. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm shaking it all off. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Hey, he's a liar. You hear what I say? He's a liar. The truth is nowhere in him. Nowhere. Nowhere. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. If anything is transpiring in your life, amen, set to destroy you, you know automatically it didn't come from God, because his purpose, amen, is to save. His purpose is to seek and to save that which is lost. It is not to destroy. You hear what I say? God's will is not to destroy, but to build, to plant. Hallelujah. To edify, to save. That's why he sent his son Jesus to die in our stead. He paid a price we couldn't. He did the very thing we could not do. He shed his precious blood on Calvary's cross, washed away our sins. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you, stand your ground. No matter what the situation, no matter what the circumstance, stand your ground. Trust God. Believe him. Speak his word. Continue to speak his word. Amen. Encourage your hearts. Brethren, amen. Glory be to God. I sure hope and pray that the Lord, amen, has, amen, blessed you. Amen. Glory be to God. I pray that the Lord, amen, has not allowed anybody to come here unfulfilled. I pray, amen, glory be to God, that this word, amen, will not only, amen, touch the lives of those that are here and those that are listening from wherever they're listening from, but those, amen, that will come hereafter. I pray, amen, glory be to God, that you are in the spirit to praise his holy name, and that, amen, you are making God way, way bigger than your problems. Amen, glory be to God. Is there anyone, amen, in need of prayer? I don't want to cut nobody off. Amen. The number to dial is 760-888-5875. Amen. You can type up in that chat room. Amen. Glory be to God. Let me know, amen, what your prayer request is. Amen. Glory be to God. And we'll kindly take it before the Lord. Amen. You that are already on the phone lines, all you have to do is hit the number one button. Amen. And it'll bring you in. Glory to God. I pray, amen, glory to God, that each and every last one of you, amen, take this word, amen, take this spirit, take the Holy Ghost along with you, and drive the enemy out. Drive him out. Your praise is a weapon, and he can't stand it, nor can he stand up against it. That's why he seeks so hard to get that praise out of your mouth. Come on here, y'all. When we're going through struggles, amen, trials and tribulations, the last thing, mostly, amen, most of the time we want to do is praise God. Our flesh don't want to do nothing but sulk. Amen, glory be to God. But, amen, we got to be like the man of God in the Bible. So, magnify the Lord. Why art thou disquieted in me? Amen. Magnify the Lord. Glorify his holy name. So, glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, my God, I'm going to behave myself, but I'm telling you right now, I will never cease from praising the name of my Lord. I will never cease. Hallelujah. Brethren, amen, if all hearts and minds are clear, and amen, glory be to God, we're going to go ahead and let you go. And we'll be back here again, if the Lord say the same, next week, Monday, for, amen, our spiritual boot camp. Amen, we're going to start that up next week, Monday, if the Lord say the same. Amen, we've been hindered. quite a lot here lately, but amen, glory be to God. And that will be no more. Come Monday at 8 p.m., we will be here for spiritual boot camp. Amen, glory be to God. Getting, amen, where we need to be for ministry. But that's our purpose, brethren, the fivefold ministry. We're here, amen, to edify the body of Christ, to build up, hello somebody, not tear down, to build up the body of Christ, to strengthen and encourage, amen, glory be to God, the body of Christ. That's what we're here for, according to Ephesians chapter number 4, that's our job. The apostle, the prophet, the pastor, the evangelist, the teacher, we're here to edify. That means to build up, to strengthen, to empower. That's what we're here for. We're not here to kill each other, tear each other down. Amen, glory be to God. That's not the work of the Lord. If you go back into your Bibles, the only people that Jesus actually rebuked in the open were those who knew better, but wouldn't do better. Hello, somebody. And we thank God once again, man, for all of his word on tonight. Thank God for each and every one of you being here with us on tonight. Amen. Keep us in your prayers. Amen. Glory be to God. I mean, keep us in your prayers. All right. Lord willing, we'll see you, amen, again on next week, Monday. And I pray that, amen, each and every last one of you have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Amen. Glory be to God. And Lord be willing, we'll see you again soon, all right? Talk to you later. Minister Robin Lynn, go ahead and take us out of here if you would. Appreciate you.
You just listened to Word of Flame Radio, a ministry of Powerhouse Ministries International. We will be broadcasting Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time right here on blogtalkradio.com/Word of Flame. You can reach us by email at powerhouseministriesintl@gmail.com or toll free at 1-800-953-5301. You can also find Apostle Timberlake on Facebook, Twitter, and Google. Tune in to Word of Flame Radio and break the knob.
Please let me clarify, amen, it's Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. Central Standard Time. Amen. Glory be to God. God bless you. Good night, one and all.
Thank you for using Blog.